Make some quick mead. Got a gallon carboy, and I put some dried blueberries that probably are on the borderline going stale. Just found this online, this recipe. I've never made mead. So anyway, you're gonna put that on the scale, tear it, or zero it out, whatever. Zero. There we go. And get your honey. This is orange blossom. Bulk honey. I mean, I've had other honey that's a lot better, but I'm trying to be reasonable in the price range. So we're gonna pour that in there until we get whoops, till we get to 3 pounds. This is kind of like when I'd made my jute wine from all those juices and put about 3 cups of sugar in there. So about 3 pounds of honey would be like 3 cups of sugar. So we're gonna pour that until we get up to 3 pounds. Still pouring out of honey, so we're gonna go switch to the rest of it with this organic honey. Guessing it's from, factory farm or something. It'd have to be an organic one. And like many other times in life, I got distracted while I was pouring, so now we're at 3.35. But yeah, I'm gonna clean that off. Start filling up with some hot water. I mean, I guess you could probably use boiling water if you wanted to, or not boiling, pretty hot to really liquefy the honey. So we're gonna fill that up. And we're gonna mix it up. I'm just gonna use two hands and hold it on one side and the other. I don't have anything to hold the phone right now, but just mix it up. All right, now I've done 2 batches before this. And if you don't leave enough room, it'll foam over. Like 15 minutes ago, I just made a batch. And it's already foaming up and out of the airlock. And it was about down to here. And I have blueberries in there, so I might leave a little bit more head space. I didn't expect it to do this, but I've never done me this is just plain honey. This is my first flavored experiment with dried blueberries in there. And there it goes. It's really foaming over. Now there's another one I made, which is weird. This one is not foaming over as much. Well, not at all. So, and I one of them was the orange blossom honey, and the other one was just the organic honey. So this one's kind of just humming along slowly. But I wasn't really planning to do a third batch. I figured I'd just film it because I haven't done anything in a while. But I'm using this yeast, but there's basically nothing in there. But I'm still gonna see if we can get a ferment off of just this little bit of yeast and a little tiny bit that's in the very bottom of that. Let's just say you found that in a trash pile, and this is your last chance to make mead and harvest yeast for mankind here. All right, this is gonna be a pain in the butt, especially doing it on camera and getting the thing to focus. But anyway, put your yeast in there. I put my yeast in there, and I did not sanitize this carboy. These two, I had got the star sand out and did it. But even when I did those other wines, I barely sanitized anything, and the only failure I ever had was watermelon. So I don't know if it's because it was watermelon, but it just, that was nasty tasting. So I did not sanitize this. Plus, I used dried fruit that, who knows, could have its own yeast in it. But and I used microscope, tiny little specks of yeast I had left, so this is probably gonna take a long time. There's all kinds of clutter here. A long time to even probably start doing anything, but I always like to see things progress, even if it is, on a very small level and grow to something. So, but it can't be much worse than this here. That's humming along a little too much. Now I have to keep it in the sink or clean that airlock out and do all that stuff. But
I got other stuff to do, so I'll let that sit in the sink, and man, hopefully this thing comes out good. I made a blueberry that wine stuff out of the blueberry naked drink, and that turned out good. So I just got that 3 pounds of honey net from what is it, the Survival Podcast forum or something like that. So I just took the quick reference off of that, and that'll be a starting point, and I'll go from there what I do. And that's the other thing you gotta worry about. If you have fruit flies, which we have them, and you just don't want to get, you have to keep an eye on these, because fruit flies will get lay eggs inside of there and actually infiltrate your airlock. They can't generally get up in there and in the drink, but something to look at. Rack after fermentation, then rack again a few weeks.